Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Thursday, the feast of Saint Monica. Our mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance antiphon. The woman who fears the Lord will herself be praised. Her children have called her most blessed. Her husband has sung her praises.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Now let us pray. O God, who consoled the sorrowful and who mercifully accepted the motherly tears of Saint Monica for the conversion of her son Augustine, grant us through the intercession of them both that we may bitterly regret our sins and find the grace of your pardon. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and sustains our brother to the church of God that is in Corinth, to you who have been sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be holy with all those everywhere who call upon the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way with all discourse and all knowledge, as this testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable, on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you were called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, I will praise your name forever, Lord.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
Every day will I bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. His greatness is unsearchable.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
Generation after generation praises your works and proclaims your might. They speak of the splendor of your glorious majesty and tell of your wondrous works.
I will praise your name forever, Lord.
They discourse of the power of your terrible deeds and declare your greatness. They publish the fame of your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your justice.
I will praise your name forever, Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia. Stay awake, for you do not know when the Son of Man will come. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, stay awake, for you do not know on which day your Lord will come. Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour of night when the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake and not let his house be broken into. So too, you must also be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come. Who then is the faithful and prudent servant, whom the master has put in charge of his household to distribute to them their food at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on his arrival finds doing so. Amen, I say to you, he will put him in charge of all his property. But if that wicked servant says to himself, my master is long delayed and begins to beat his fellow servants and eat and drink with drunkards, the servant's master will come on an unexpected day and at an hour unknown and will punish him severely and assign him a place with the hypocrites where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, as we mentioned last Tuesday, we were looking at the Gospel, the part of Matthew which talks about the woes of the Pharisees. And as we mentioned yesterday, we're reading now from the 24th chapter. Yesterday and Tuesday was the 23rd chapter of Matthew. And here you have series of warnings of the Lord, right? in the final day, so to speak. And then tomorrow we will be reading from chapter 25, which is really that final chapter before it goes into the Passion of Christ. So today you have Christ, in a sense, giving you can call it a warning, which says stay awake, no? But let's take a look at three, really not so much warnings, but really three graces that we can pray for. Of course, the first one that we want to look at is that whole point of always being alert, as the Lord says, stay awake, be alert. But that thing also of always being at the disposal of God. And if you wish a certain sense of availability, that when the Lord comes, one is always ready and one is always available. No? And then the second point that I wish to reflect on is the fidelity to work, the fidelity to mission. And the third is a sense of detachment also, no? at the end of it all. First is the saying what the Lord says, that stay awake for you do not know when the Lord is coming. And you know, there's a very interesting story, supposedly, I think, of St. John Berkmans, one of the young Jesuit saints, wherein supposedly he was playing what was something like the equivalent of handball. So they were playing, and he was asked, what would you do if you know you're going to die now or soon? And he said, I will just continue doing what I'm doing. And I think that's the spirit of the first part of the Gospel. That sense of readiness and also that sense of being always ready to go or ready wherever God calls you to or sends you. If your time comes, what will you do? I will do what I am doing. And I think that is a very, very clear sense of readiness. When you think about it, di ba, pag tinignan mo yung buhay mo, alam mong wala kang inaaksayang panahon. Because any moment, kahit anong panahon na tawagin ka ng Diyos, pakiramdam mo, ready ka. So that means wala kang ginagawa na hindi naaayon sa dapat mong klaseng pamumuhay para matugunan yung tawag ng Diyos. No? And you know, another way of looking at it is also that sense of availability. We've talked about this, especially during the time of Lent. We were talking about that Ignatian characteristic of availability, that wherever the mission calls, one is available, one is ready to go, one is ready. In fact, there's an image of Ignatius in one of the biographies written about him. The title of the biography is With One Foot Race, meaning to say at any given point that the Spirit of God directs you somewhere, you're ready to go. And that is also the spirit of what the Gospel is saying, that we must always be prepared, we must be alert and ready for the Lord to come or ready for the Lord to call us. The second point is that fidelity to mission. Yung makikita natin doon sa pangalawang kwento, sinasabi dito ng kwento na kung yung isang pinagkatiwala, the prudent servant, yung pinagkatiwalaan ng Panginoon or ng master of the house, with certain responsibilities. Pagka siya ay tapat dun sa kanyang mga responsibilidad, pag dumating yung kanyang amo, makikitang tapat siya sa trabaho, magagantimpalaan siya. Kaya nga ito yung tinatawag na gantimpala ng katapatan, the reward of fidelity. And I think in our own life, I think fidelity to what God wants us to do, fidelity to what God is asking us to do to make this world better, will be rewarded. Of course, we always do it not just simply for the reward, but knowing that it is what God wants us to do. And I think the reward is knowing that one is faithful to God's will. I think yung katapatan natin mismo, yun ang gantimpala natin. Alam naman natin yung pakiramdam pagka, halimbawa, alam natin na ginagawa natin yung dapat natin gawin. Alam, merong satisfaction eh, na payapa, na tahimik, na nagagalak ka, na nagagampanan mo yung dapat mong, yung mga responsibilidad mo. I think that is the second point that I invite you to reflect on, that second point of that fidelity to what God wants us to do. And then the final point, let me just change my final point. No? Let me just talk about Saint Monica. Today is her feast day, and because I just want to link it to fidelity to her mission. You know, her mission is to be the mother of Augustine. I think that's one of her great contributions to our church and our faith, that she was the mother of Augustine who never tired praying for her. And when you look at it, that was fidelity to her mission as the mother of Augustine. That was her mission in life. To pray for her son, to pray for the conversion of Augustine, which in the end, no, her prayer led to his conversion, and he became one of the most revered saints of the church. And I guess there you see again that fidelity to prayer, the fidelity and her dedication and devotion to her son, which I think are very important Christian qualities also, Christian virtues. Our fidelity to the people to whom we are sent. And together with that fidelity to mission is fidelity to prayer. In the end, fidelity to mission must be accompanied by fidelity to prayer. You know, mission is not automatic. That even as you live out your mission, you need to constantly pray and discern. And most certainly, Saint Monica is an exemplar of prayer. And really a real role model for prayer and fidelity and patience. And panalangin natin na kagaya niya ay tayo'y matutong maging tapat sa panalangin, patapat sa ating pagdadasal para sa ibang tao, lalong-lalo na yung binigay sa atin ng Panginoon para ipagdasal. Tapat tayo sa misyon at kaakibat nitong pagsasabuhay ng misyon ay ang katapatan din sa panalangin na mahalagang mahalaga para masabuhay natin ang misyon natin ng buong naaayon sa Espiritu ng Diyos. So let us pray for this and ask also Saint Monica to pray for us. And we pray especially today for mothers. Now she is, I guess, the patroness of mothers. In the name of the Father and of the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
In the Gospel, the Lord Jesus called us to watch for the day of His return. Let us come to the Father in prayer, watching and waiting for His beloved Son. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may not be satisfied with what she has done, but continue to proclaim the gospel of repentance and realize the need for conversion and renewal. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our communities may be fitting places for the building of God's kingdom by our respect, love, and concern for one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may always be ready for the coming of God's kingdom by remaining watchful but never fearful, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the dying may seek God's will in their trials and sufferings, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may be found ready to meet the Lord, whom they longed to see face to face, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And as we offer this sixth Novena Mass for the ABS-CBN employees, both those who are being retrenched at the end of the month and those who are staying, we invite you to continue to pray with us, praying for all the employees. And together now, let us pray together the prayer of Kapamilyas.
The prayer of Kapamilyas. Father, Son, and Spirit, out of love for us, you sent the Son to be God with us, to serve and to save us. You are the source of all mission and all graces you give to sustain this mission and to bring it to completion. We come to you now with this faith that you called us through our founder, your servant and son, Henny, to this mission to be in the service of the Filipino, and that ABS-CBN exists only for this and will continue to exist whenever and wherever there is a Filipino in need. May we always be, wherever we are, in the service of the Filipino. This was, is, and will always be our source of union of hearts and minds, our inspiration to love and to serve you in all our kapamilyas. Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, through you, with you, and in you, we, all of us, are forever kapamilya. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
We bring you these sacrificial gifts, O Lord, to commemorate Blessed Saint Monica, humbly entreating that they may bestow on us both pardon and salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage, their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We remember especially those who passed away during this time of the pandemic. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Monica, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all, and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and never blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians, and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May the working of this divine sacrament enlighten and inflame us, Almighty God, on this feast day of Blessed Monica, that we may ever fervent with holy desires and abound in good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
On Sunday, we'd like to invite you to join us in a 3 p.m. rosary. It's going to be shown in my prayer channel of ABS-CBN and also in ABS-CBN Facebook page and also One Palm PH Facebook page. It's going to be that's the final day of our novena for those who will be retrenched. So please join us also in the rosary, and we'll have a virtual procession. But actually, the procession is from one image to another. So please join us at 3 p.m. this coming Sunday. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.